Hey, it's Aaron. Today I'm in front of a 2021 Toyota Sienna Hybrid. The engine is running right now because it's very cold out and the van's only been running for maybe 3-4 minutes. I wanted to clear all the windows before I talked about this car. So let's get to it. So the Sienna is all new this year, completely different. They changed everything. The hybrid in particular is a big deal because Toyota literally engineered this van to be a hybrid. So the gas model is kind of, it still exists, but they're kind of trying to push it aside to really promote this version. So the hybrid has a wonderful powertrain. It's a little 2.5 liter four cylinder, and then that mates to a couple of electric motors. In this one, it creates all-wheel drive, and it, as far as I know, the hybrid model is all-wheel drive by default. So you have a motor back here running these rear wheels, and then you have the usual CVT with motors on it up front, and it's a wonderful setup. Gives you about 245 horsepower. So one thing about driving the Sienna is it's just not in a hurry. It's a little bit slow. You don't get a whole lot of feedback as a driver, so there's not a lot of vibration in the floor through the pedals. There's no feedback at all in the steering wheel. It's very kind of sloppy feeling. So for those who prefer a sportier or a faster feeling drive, this is definitely not it. But on the flip side of that, I think most people who are looking at a minivan who are in that market, that's probably not terribly important to them. What is important to them? The MPG numbers, the cost of the van, how big the interior is, those are the points that matter. So let's get into that. So to talk about fuel economy first, the Sienna is rated at 36 miles per gallon on the highway. I did a highway loop here. We're going at 75 miles an hour at high altitude. We're at 6,400 feet here. I do a 40-ish mile, it's about 41 miles loop. Fill up, run, refill, do the math, right? I beat that 36. I got about 36 and a half. I think most people driving this reasonably on the highway, they should be able to get 36 or better. I think there will be a lot of people that will be pushing the 37 and 38 miles per gallon in this. The combined rating in this is 35. So with a hybrid, one of the advantages you have is around town, you're going to be driving all electric relatively often. And this does a very good job of that. All Toyota hybrids are really well done. This is no exception. Now, as far as price tag goes, we'll look at a Monroney in a minute, but this is the top level of this van. So this is the most expensive it can be. So after we look at the interior, we'll check out that Monroney. So this is me in the back seat. This is the second row of seating here. These are captain's chairs. The Sienna in this particular setup seats seven. So three in the back, two right here, two up front. I have lots of headroom. I've got probably a couple of inches, inch and a half maybe. I've got lots of leg room. So you can see right here where my knees are. This seat is geared towards me at 6'3" up front. And it's also slid back a little bit because when you enter and exit from the front, the seat moves. And you can see I've got a good 3 inches of knee room right there. That's beauty. This seat that I'm sitting in moves back and forth as well as tilt and recline. And there's just lots of ease of entry. The doors are electrically actuated, so they open and close themselves. There's a button down here for that. There's also buttons up in between the driver and the passenger on the top console, and you can pull the door handles either inside or out to move the door. So there's lots of easy options for that. Grab handles for getting in and out if you have mobility issues. Just lots of well done, well thought out things in this van. Lots of storage, tons of it. Each of these seats, you have a door pocket for a drink, you have a door pocket for stuff, you have a drink holder on the side of these captain's chairs. There's plenty back there, and there's USBs all the way around for everybody. The rear seat entertainment system is an add-on. We'll talk about the pricing for that kind of stuff, but it's the same giant screen and wireless headphones you had before. down on the bottom console in between the driver and front passenger on the back side here is an HDMI plug and a 120 outlet. So lots of just great thought went into the little things in this van. Let's go look at the cargo area. So as you can see back here, the cargo area is really big. The third row being up, there's still tons of tub down here. It goes down maybe 7-8 inches. So you have a deep tub to drop things into. These seats, of course, when they fold down, they go into that tub and make a flat loading floor. I'll get you some close-ups of that. And then let's go talk about the front seats and the technology in this. So here in the front of the car, the driver and front passenger seats are very, very nicely done. This particular model has both heated and cooled front seating. There is also this new infotainment, which is up and off the dash rather than being embedded, that allowed Toyota to lower the dash a little and give more visibility out the front. That's a kind of a nice setup. This is a full touch screen. Then you have climate controls down here and so forth. Drink holders abound in this car. You have one, two right here, two more right here. That's four just up front, not including anything in the door pockets. You also have wireless charging in this particular one. There's a USB here. There's also more USBs in the storage. I love this storage bin because it opens, but you don't have to take your arm off the armrests on either side. Wonderful little thought, just a brainy idea. This shelf right here is also really cool because you can throw several items on there, you know, extra keys, passenger's phone, as well as your phone, things like that. There's also another phone holder right here in the front of that drink holder. Just smart little things that were done throughout this van. Driver's controls are very, very obvious. So anybody driving who is familiar with Toyota layouts should be familiar with this. Anybody who's just familiar with anybody's layout will still understand most of it. Cruise control's on the right, driver information screen is on the left, and most of the rest of it is stuff you're only going to be occasional use. So over here you have a few things for controlling the doors and some other stuff. I really like the way that they've done things in this. This particular model also has a smart rear view. So what that means is you can pull the rear view forward like this, and it uses a camera in the back to see out, to show you what's behind you. And then forward, it's like a regular rear view with auto dimming. That's great because when you have a bunch of people or you have a bunch of stuff in here and it's getting in the way of seeing what's happening behind you in traffic, you can just flip this forward and use that camera instead. Another advantage that most minivans have now, and it really should be a standard feature, is this little mirror. This little convex mirror right here allows you to see the entire passenger cabin so you can have a conversation without interfering with your rear view. You don't have to tilt the rear view down to see little kids in the back seats or something. Also, this comes with Toyota's full suite of crash mitigation and other things. Those are standard across the board in every Toyota. They're standard in this van. This has some sunroofs and a few other things included as well. It's just a really well done van. So let's look at the price tag. Pulling up the Monroney here, the total price for this van is $54,212 with delivery. Now, that sounds like a lot of money, but remember, this is the very top end of this van. So this is the Platinum all-wheel drive model with the hybrid system. The base price for this particular one is $50,460. You add on $1,400 and change for that rear seat and entertainment system. That's up to you, take or leave it. My kids are old enough now that I would probably just leave it because they all have their own tablets and other gadgets, so really don't need that. But it's up to you again. The 1500 watt inverter, that's a very good thing to have, gives you power in the back and in the very back. Household outlets, really nice to have those, so I would say that's totally worth it. Digital rear view mirror, the $200 option, totally would pay for that. That makes excuse me, That makes driving this van so much easier. Next, you have the accessory plugs, the all-weather liners, the accessory package, all-weather liners, cargo liner, take or leave that, and the crossbars, which are for the luggage rack on top. All of those things are good to have. I would not say no to them. So very, very well done. And honestly, for the price that you're paying for this van, that seems like a lot of money. $54,000 is not, you know, it's not cheap. But I would put this model, the Platinum model, on par with almost any luxury vehicle. It's just very, very posh in here and very comfortable and really smartly done. Tri-zone climate, you have lots of little places to put things, you have plenty of room for everything, and then when you need to, all the stuff folds and moves and gets out of the way and gives you a huge amount of cargo space. So just nicely done. Toyota did a wonderful job on this. My single complaint is just in the way it drives. Other than that, beautiful van. Toyota did a top shelf job on this. So there you go. That's what I got. This has been Aaron. Talk to you again soon.